Welcome to the video news of the week. A Colebrook manufacturer of clothing, Codet, based in Coaticook, Quebec, is currently making plans to expand its operation in town. Currently employing over 25 people, the company told the Chronicle this week that if everything goes as hoped, it will be doubling its workforce in the 11,500-foot addition.
So right now we're doing an addition to get some federal contract. We have some line we're bringing back from Canada to here. It's the same machinery that we are going to use for federal contract later. So we start with that line and work the machine and have experience with the girls to do the garment. And after that, we try to get some contract. And we try to hire probably around 25 girls.
So it'd be an expansion of about, would it be like double?
Double the building and the employee, yeah. I think it's going to be around mid of September, end of September, it's going to be the opening, and we were ready to start sewing and start the production, yeah. We're based in Quebec, in Coaticook, since 1946, and we have five different places in Canada, and we have a place in Newport, Vermont, the warehouse. This is where we ship our final stuff, and they ship that to our customer.
Now tell me about what you were talking with Congresswoman Kuster. What, she's offered to help in some way?
Yeah, right now we're doing stuff with PTAP. It's a program to help us to get some federal contract. And she just told me she's going to send the letters to try to help me to get some contract and make a recommendation letters for me.
New Hampshire Congresswoman Annie Kuster was at Codet on Monday as part of her Congress at Your Company tour, seeing firsthand the production line at the Colebrook operation.
This is a wonderful time to be in Colebrook. It's beautiful. And I'm here on my Congress at Your Company visits. I've gone all over the district visiting companies, talking about creating jobs and growth, economic development, and particularly important here in the North Country. So I'm excited that I talked with Stefan today. Big Bill is looking at a program that we refer to as Make It in America. We want goods that are made in America to be sold to the federal government for uniforms, for different, if there are military applications or homeland security, border patrol, that type of thing. And we have a procurement program where he can get technical assistance for putting together the bid, and I'm here to help with that. I'm going to support their application for Make It in America and make sure that we're making goods right here at home and growing jobs right here. We're headed up to Pittsburgh. We've got a great program this afternoon on wounded warriors and getting a chance to see the rehabilitation and just a peaceful place in the woods and the mountains and the out of doors for our wounded warriors. I'm a member of the Veterans Affairs Committee, so it's particularly important to me that we bring services to veterans. And I'm also excited that we're going to have new community health centers for our veterans in Berlin and Colebrook. So we're making some progress, and I'm just here to check up on how things are going and enjoy the beautiful day here in the North Country.
You can read more in this week's Colebrook Chronicle. At 8.05 p.m. on August 8th, a pickup truck towing a small trailer with a boat was traveling north on Route 3 by Spruce Cone Cabins in Pittsburgh when the operator lost control of the vehicle. It struck guardrails, propelling the vehicle up on a ledge, resulting in the vehicle rolling onto the driver's side. The two men inside were trapped, and the windshield had to be removed in order to extricate them. The passenger, Kenneth Wayne Ainsworth, 67, of Bartlett, sustained head injuries and was flown to Dartmouth Medical Center. The operator of the vehicle, Richard Johnston, 47, also of Bartlett, sustained injuries to his ribs and lacerations and was taken to UCVH in Colebrook. As a result of the investigation, the Pittsburgh police arrested Johnston for aggravated DWI and an open container violation. The vehicle appeared to be totaled and was taken away by a wrecker. Both men were not wearing seatbelts.
On Saturday, the Grofton Fish and Game Club held a youth 4-H shotgun shooting clinic at the shooting range in Grofton. The family event aimed to introduce youth to shooting sports, with safety techniques and clay target shooting. The instructors for the event were Jack Bowen and Jack Reagan.
That's where you want to be looking at it. You want to be looking right down here, right at the target. Then you know you're lined up.
Hello, I'm Jack Reagan, and I'm involved with the Groveton Fish and Game Club here in Groveton, and we're putting on a shoot today that is for, it's a family affair, but it's for children that are between the ages of 12 and 17. And the purpose of the shoot today is to introduce the kids to safe firearms handling, as well as shooting a shotgun. The shotgun that we're going to be shooting today is a 20 gauge, so it's not a real hard kicker. And it will give the kids an opportunity to shoot clay targets, and get instruction from people who have been doing this for many years. So we're looking forward to having a good crew. We're going to have some hot dogs for the kids, and we've got a beautiful day, so it should be a good day for us.
Northumberland State Police held their National Night Out event last week. Demonstrations were held showcasing different safety and rescue techniques by local and state police officials. A canine demonstration was given by State Trooper Chris Ladd, with Northumberland Officer Jonathan Woodworth assisting. Later, a water rescue demonstration was performed in the community pool.
You're all set. Get the Groveton Fire Department. Okay.
The small hamlet of Eaton Corner, Quebec, came to life with music and activities for the annual Old Fashioned Day at the Eaton Corner Museum. This has been an annual event since 2006, held at the Cookshire Fairgrounds. Artisans and craftsmen were on hand to showcase skills from all across the Eastern Township's history. Last Saturday, Barry Berwick and Nancy Lloyd threw open their doors for their annual community barbecue in Sawyerville. Close to 150 turned out for the event, a much-loved happening in the small community. Music was provided by a host of local performers, with Kendra Parnell at the forefront singing to the crowd.
A massive parade rolled through downtown Coaticook, Quebec last Saturday, helping mark the town's 150th anniversary. Part of the annual Agricultural Expo held each August in Coaticook, the parade, the first through the downtown in 10 years, saw 55 organizations take part. The parade kicked off at 1 p.m. and lasted for over an hour, with thousands in attendance.
I'm
Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by the Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital in Colebrook. Visit their website at ucvh.org. Compassionate healthcare close to home. LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at laperlesiga.com. Colebrook Plumbing and Heating in Colebrook. Why heat with oil when you can heat economically with wood? Come see our whole house wood boiler solutions currently on sale. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. All eyes were in the sky this weekend with the supermoon shining bright. It reached its peak between Saturday and Sunday in this video taken in Clarksville as the moon rose in the evening sky. Friday brings rain with a colder than normal range of temperatures, from a high of 60 to a low of 46. Saturday warms up a bit with a high of 67, and Sunday closes out the weekend with rain and thundershowers, with a high of 68 and a low of 50 degrees. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.